let's talk about some dimensions of quality. And what do we mean by dimensions of quality? We're talking about aspects, specific aspects of quality when it comes to a service or a product. So when we talk about service qualities, there are five dimensions that are often used by customers to judge the quality of the service. And then when we look at the quality of goods, there are about eight characteristics that customers use to judge whether that product is of high quality. So let's start with the service quality. First is reliability. I mean, do you perform accurately and dependably? Can we rely on you? The degree of reliability when it comes to you doing your service is an example of reliability. So when it comes to a hospital setting and you say your turnaround time is 10 minutes, when you get there, 10 minutes you'll be seen by someone, is that true? Is that accurate? And if it is, then you're a reliable hospital. But if I have to wait 2 hours, then that aspect of quality, you're not up to par. Next, we have responsiveness, and that's just your willingness to help, how fast you're able to respond to customers, how prompt is your service, are you responsive? Again, if you are responsive, if you have a promise on your website to say that we respond to all inquiries in 24 hours, but it takes you 72, you're not that responsive, right? That is an aspect of a service quality that people typically evaluate. And then the next one is assurance. Now, this one is about being knowledgeable and courteous to the people that you serve and giving them the trust and confidence they need in your services. Again, we're thinking about a doctor. Have you ever spoken with a doctor that really didn't seem too confident about what he was telling you about your health? And you were like, "Doc, you don't sound too convincing." You don't trust them. Right? That aspect of quality can really rub you the wrong way, especially when someone doesn't really sound like they know what they're talking about, or they're doing internet searches while you're trying to figure out what's going on with you. Doc, I can do that myself. I need to be assured that you know what's wrong with me with this diagnosis, right? So that's another aspect of quality where when it comes to service, is very important to the consumer. And then another one, too, is empathy that goes neck and neck with assurance, is just showing that you care and really focusing on the customer, especially, again, going back to the doctor example. You want your doctor to be concerned about your well-being, your health. I mean, yes, you're paying for the service, but at the same time, you want someone that can express empathy, especially if they have to tell you that you have a terminal disease or something of that nature. You want someone that can be compassionate in that type of setting. And sometimes people can share that type of information without expressing any empathy. The death of a loved one, right? You have to be empathetic when communicating those types of things to people because it's a service quality that people tend to evaluate. And then the tangibles. Now, this aspect of quality is not so much specific to the service, but it's more so of where the services take place, the appearance of the facility, equipment, the personnel, how they communicate, things of that nature, right? Is your hospital dirty all the time? Or your doctor's office dirty and needs cleaning? Do you treat the staff poorly when the customers are there? So these tangibles or tangible aspect is just about what you see from that experience when we're talking about the service qualities, the dimensions of service quality. And next we have the qualities of goods. First, performance. Does the product do what you said it would do? Right? If you buy a television that you say is going to work, you want it to work the way that it's supposed to work, right? So does the primary features and the primary operating characteristics, are they up to par when it comes to the product? Second is the features, and these are the secondary characteristics, right? Does the remote work that comes with the television, does it have the internet and all of the apps and things like that? Is it a smart TV like you said it was? Does it do all of these extra bells and whistles that's supposed to come with the product. Are they there and do they function? You're being evaluated on these things when you're talking about a specific product. Next, reliability. Now, reliability is a service quality as well, right? We're talking about, are you reliable from the service? Are you dependable when it comes to the service? Are you accurate when it comes to the service? Can we rely on you? Now we're talking about, can we rely on the product that you sold to us when it comes to quality? And this is defined differently. It's actually the length of time the product will function before it fails, or the probability it will function for a stated period of time. Now, we're talking about, if we're looking at a new television, those can last a while, right? I don't want to pay $1,500 for this high-end television only for it to break down and not work in 2 years. I want it to last much longer than that. Otherwise, I could have spent $400 or $500 and maybe not had as high of an expectation. So is your product reliable? How long will it function before it fails based on that product? And then next is conformance. Does it match pre-designed characteristics? So now we're getting a little bit more specific, right? Especially if an example I used earlier in the course was the building of a house. Right. If you sit down with a builder and you have land and you're building a house in a specific area, does that house look like the blueprint? Does it conform? If so, and it's built to specification, awesome, great quality. But if the staircase is opposite of where it was supposed to be and you put the big room on the wrong side and the small room on the wrong, you built it, but the quality, you didn't conform to specification. So from a conformance perspective, the quality could be poor if you don't follow things based on the preset standard. And next we have durability, right? So when we buy things, especially things like cell phones, we want those things to be naturally durable. It's the ability of a product to function when it's subjected to hard and frequent use. That doesn't have to just be a cell phone. That can be a car. That can be anything that's going to be subjected to hard and frequent use. A laptop, you may want to be durable if you're going to be traveling with it and working on site. Let's say if you work at a construction company, but you have to keep a laptop with you all the time, you're probably going to go through some stuff with that laptop, right? So it needs to be real durable. So durability is another area where products are evaluated by consumers. And then we have serviceability. Now, this is the service aspect of when we're talking about a product, not a service, but serviceability, speed, courtesy, and competency of repair. So when it comes to maintenance, let's say whether it's a warranty claim or maybe you taking your car back to the dealership for an oil change. What is the service like when you go in to get your free oil change after you purchased the car? That is an aspect of quality that people will definitely evaluate. And then we got next, the aesthetics, how the product looks, feel, taste, touch, sounds. All of that is the aesthetics of the product. And that can be almost anything, right? Does your television sound and looks as well as they said it would? The food, does it look? Very rarely it doesn't. You see those great pictures of the food at the restaurant and in the commercial, and then you order it and it comes on your plate and you're like, this isn't the same thing. Well, anyway, aesthetics, poor. That's another aspect of quality in which you're being evaluated. And sometimes that food comes out looking exactly how it looks on the picture if you go to the right restaurant. And then lastly, we have perceived quality. This is image, advertising, and the brand name of the product. So we like to think certain products have a certain level of quality just based on what it looks like, the imagery and the advertising, right? It's perception, our perceived quality of a particular product. We've seen things advertised before, and it makes us feel as if we're going to get this product that it's just going to be so great, and then it's not so great, right? We feel like we've been bamboozled because we've been bamboozled. So perceived quality is also another aspect where the customer can sometimes feel deceived when it comes to the quality of a product. But that's it. That's 8 for quality of goods and 5 for quality of services. Key takeaways: when it comes to knowing these are just aspects of or dimensions of quality in which you can evaluate services and evaluate products.